assistants. Not really assistants here, but my colleagues here to distribute each one of the handout. Okay, so this is a continuation. This actually, I'm giving you the handouts. It's also the information from what is a differentiated instruction. Actually, you can browse it. I give you links there because I also browse that from the internet. Then there are a lot, if you want to go deeper into it, a lot of links, and you can use a lot of things here. But here, we just are getting some of the practical ways that we can use in our class, in our own class, as language teachers. Because this differentiated instruction is not only for English teaching, but it's for all subjects. It is applicable for all subjects, whatever you are teaching, science, mathematics, social studies, geography, religion. This differentiated instruction can be used because it deals with the learners' different ability, mixed ability, their learning styles, and their learning, their interests. On the board, on the slide, I have the honor to say that I took again this, because this is our presentation last time with Ibu Celestine. So I took this one activity. So I also wrote down there Celestine Zainuddin's crazy presentation. So there are three I took from her. Now, for the differentiated instruction, because we did it together when we went to a branch, I forgot. So I feel, but I have to modify it for you because different purpose. Now, anyway, this box, how do you say, table, there are four types of learners here. You have the artful artists. It's not in your handouts. Number two, we have the capable connector. So the first one is, it was called artful artists, and then capable connector, and the discussion director, the word wizard. Usually this is also used for collaborative learning, in assigning roles for the students in a group. But this one is for differentiated this serves as a differentiated instruction for individual, maybe, or for a group. So you might be able to form or ask your students to form an artful artist, discussion director, the capable connector, and the word wizard. What is Luz talking about? In your handout, there is the scarecrow. At the back part, at the page five, I would like you to see. There is the text there, A Scare at the Airport, A Scare at the Airport by John Freeman, for the pyramid frame. That is for the pyramid frame. But we can use it for this. But we change an interview between the husband and the wife. It can be between the the writer of this and the child, yeah, and the father, it can be changed. So what do you mean by here? If you are an artful artist, you can read the short story, this story, the A Scare at the Airport by John Freeman. You can read it and use some form of artwork to represent a significant scene or idea from the reading. You see what I mean? Now, I don't know your preferences yet. Yeah, because I just met you this morning. How many hours already? So, you have to identify yourselves now. You have to reflect on your preference. This is learning preference. What is your preference? Oh, I like to be in art as an artful artist, because there are four groups. Yeah, there are four groups now. Then, so I would like you to act out which one of you is the artist. Later, we will do it later, after I explain to you, not really explaining, because most of the things here, you can read it yourself, but I'll just go over with it, the underlying theories, and this is our next activity. I'm trying to explain this to you now, so you will have a more easier way of understanding what is inside here. Because a while ago, I only talked to you about struggling learners, on-level learners, and highly able learners. Ano yung apaan lagi to? Art for artists, ada lagi, the discussion director, the capable ko rin, apaan ito? These are learning preferences. Learning style kan, tadi ada to. Learning style, you know already, yeah, the visual, the auditory, and what is it, kinesthetic, tactile and kinesthetic. Okay. These are your preferences. Okay. Jadi, I will describe to you you are going to do an artwork. Later you have to do it, because I want you to feel how to execute this kind of activities, because if you feel it, then you can apply it in your classroom. That's what my most trainers did with me before. That's why, okay, we feel it, we experience it. Or maybe you can, you'll be thinking, I'm not an artful artist, I don't like artwork. Yeah, I don't like art. Children teachers who like children teaching, you have to like art, because you do a lot of art. Yeah, okay. Capable connector, apaan si ito? So, the capable connector usually read the short story, this one, and then think of a connection or any connections with the story and a real life situation. Yeah, that? It might be your own experience, or it might be another friend or somebody else experiences. So you see? So connect. So that's why you are called the capable connector. Now the discussion director. Wow. Our director has left already anyway. Jadi saya udah nggak salah salting ya. No problem, I'm just kidding. Okay, please read the short story and then imagine that you have the opportunity to interview the characters here. The character here, it can be husband and wife, because there is father and mother here, right? Or it can be, karena yang active di sini is the writer, the son, I think. The son or, yeah, the son. John Freeman actually is the writer. So this is his experience. And so John Freeman, the son and the father, interview maybe. You are interviewing the son and the father about what is happening. Yeah, what questions would you ask? If maybe you pretend, what is the best situation? Why you interview the father and the son? Yeah? You are what? You are a reporter or what? Or maybe, what is it? Not really an interview, it is just asking for information. Maybe you are the aunt, you are the uncle. Hey, what's happened in the airport? So, your sister got lost, or something like that, then there will be a dialogue, an interviewing. So that will be the discussion director, you know. So you are going to interview. The word wizard, you should find words in the short story that are unusual. Adam, unusual. For you, usually, they will say that, or different. If there are no words, unusual words, different, maybe a little bit difficult to understand, or words that are important to the study plot or to the story plot. To make it easier, the word wizard, it can be also modified. Maybe the word, for you, can, it's not difficult. Hello, your teachers. So, at your level, maybe you are going to, sometimes like this, you might deal with the, how do you call that, grammar. So, you ask the word wizard to identify the past tense and where are, and maybe you can apply what Parlin said a while ago, asking the text, yeah, what is the text type and the words and the tenses used, vocabulary. So, yeah, it depends on what you, but you are playing with words. So you are going to find words. Yang simple to, find verbs. No? In what tenses? So that is the word wizard. Okay, now, what are we going to do? You group yourselves. You try to find out whether you are an artist. You think about yourself, where you are interested. It might happen that there will be udah sign aja ya. This one ini yang gampang begitu. Aduh, Bang, jadi teorinya nggak diapply lagi nih. Nggak apa-apa. Okay, so this group you are. But you need four here. Maybe you can join. Maybe you are the artful, you are the word wizard, and you are the, what is it, the director, and you are the artist. You stay together and then work together. You can feel it first before we discuss the underlying theories. Now here, so one of you will be the artful and the director and the word wizard and the discussion director. But you choose. I know her. This is artistic, very artistic. Word wizard juga dia write stories. I think it's better. If you want to write down on your table, in your board, this is a board actually, but you have your things, yeah? Huh? So how are we going to do it? You have the freedom anyway, but this one can be... but it's nice if you can write down on here, on the area, and then we can display later. Yeah, we can display. And you can, what is it? And so we can display your boards. But it will the activity that you are going to write on the board will be the last activity. It's better. This one, you just write it on a piece of paper. Yeah, paper saja. Jadi supaya cepat. Because the one you are going to share later is the one that you do on your own. You can just steal an instruction from here. So just on a piece of paper, because we don't have a lot of time, you know. Just on a piece of paper. Just on a piece of paper. If you are up for artists, then what are you going to do? Decide who's going to take that role.
How many questions?
So about 5 minutes. Can you wait for 10 minutes?
Not much of a reason though.
Which? Expelliarmus.
Discussion. Oh, yeah, okay. I will send you the what is it? If you give me, you have your emails, right?
Yeah, ma'am.
I will give you two. Yeah, and then you can email me. Usually we don't print it out. Next kali kalau di print. So that's why I summarize it into. Usually we don't print out. Yeah. Just email, I think. I will give it to you. Positive, yeah, who like ask questions, to have a discussion. That's why you can play a role as a
parent. Oh, I see.
Where will you discuss
about it? And then with the question, answer from the parents.
Yeah, it can be in the form of an interview, yeah, for the director. So, but this one is you are preparing your questions for to ask to the. For you to ask the John Freeman in the
land. Oh, I see. So you may have other committees
to a dialogue. No, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. This is okay. It can be into a dialogue, an interview. So the role play, this is you and then John Freeman. So you are the one asking, where were you? How John Freeman is going to answer. When did you realize that? This is you are asking the father, yeah?
The parents.
The parents. Where did you realize your daughter was not near you? Where did you find her? What was that? These are all really good questions. Yeah, for them to be able to answer. So in this case you will know by doing this you will know that your student has already got the understand this.
Comprehend the story, yes.
By just looking at the questions. Even there are no answers yet. Yeah, so the process. And you are the capable connector.
This is making another story. See, so connected.
Yeah. And now I will ask you, if we relate it to the struggling learners, the on-level learners, and the high-level learners, which of this activity is more appropriate? This one is highly able. This is one level. And that one.
And she is struggling drawing the picture.
She is struggling. And then for this one? It's still on level, so able to understand the what is it? But which is lower level? This one or that one? Okay. Okay. Yeah. Who would like you to share what you have? Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, so shall we discuss deeply this activity before we go on into the PowerPoint again? There are four ladies here. Would you like to discuss it with us? You want to discuss it in front of the class? I think it's better that everybody can see you. Okay, you just bring your activities, what you did, you share it with us. Yeah. Or you can stand there and they will look at you there. Oh yeah, they're over there. It's better.
Yeah.
Okay, so we are going to share what we have done. So I don't know where to wizard in the group. I position myself as a learner. So the words that came up as unusual, different, or difficult are signaled, checked in, soft teddy bear, that's unusual, pillow, and pick her up. And important words for the story are trip, scared, airport, and sleeping.
Also the key words, yeah? Yeah. To form the plot of the story. After you share all everything, and then try to relate it into the mixed ability. Here we are still talking about the learning preferences. Yeah?
Okay. I'm taking the part of discussion director. So I just realized that it would be better if I made the questions into the dialogue where someone asked the questions and the parents answered the questions. But
it's a dialogue, yeah.
Yeah. Interview. But I already prepared it and I'm too lazy to change it. So I prepared four questions that I think by reading or listening to this question without reading the story, the students can get the idea of what the story about. So the first question is, where were you? The second question, when did you realize that your daughter was not near you? Mm-hmm. And then the third one is, where did you find her? Mm-hmm. And then number four is, what was she doing when you found her?
Okay.
That would be it. Thank you.
So those are the questions that you are going to address.
Yeah, and the student who likes to scribble. That while doing that, actually, I was looking at what she was writing to get ideas.
Okay, so it's a setting. Yeah, yeah, you draw. With bubbles. It's just like a comics, actually. Okay, you see? Comic strip. Then the last one.
So I work on capable connector. So I read the reading material, try to get the feeling what the writers felt when that happened, and try to connect it with the feeling that I might have when something, but not necessarily same situation happened. So I come up with the story about when I thought I misplaced the plastic important for my material presentation. When I almost gave up, I found out that I already plugged in into my laptop. So the fear and the scare, the panic was the same. But actually, yeah. So I relate my feeling with the story with my own feelings when that happened. Yeah.
Different situation,
yeah.
but similar
feelings. Yes. Yeah. Like that.
Now, you tell us if we relate it to the mixed ability classes, which of those activities belong, we might be able. There is no answer, yes, this one, that one, and this one. But it depends later on how you are going to carry it out. So for you, this group, your answers might be different with the others, yeah. So which is the on level?
For the on-level learner, it would be the dialogue between the parents and the interviewer, something like that.
Okay.
Because the questions are not too difficult, but I think it is for the on-level learners.
Okay. And what about you, the artful artist?
I think
the Arthur artist is not really on level, but she can, she struggles.
She struggles.
She has to retell the story in words, so she used her scribbling.
Okay. Yeah, that's what all of you think, yeah, that group. And then what about the other, the connector and the word wizard?
So for the connector, I think it's a high ability student.
Highly able, yeah.
Highly able.
You can say high ability or highly able.
Highly able student, learner. Because we need to analyze the situation, we need to find out where we can also put the similar feelings into different situations and to grasp the understanding of the situation, things like that. So it requests for higher ability to really...
For higher order, LOT and the XOT, the lower order thinking skills, and then the higher, this one is higher order thinking skills already. Ah, okay, and
what
about the discussion? I only
like
the word wizard.
Okay, in my opinion, the word wizard activity will be suitable for struggling students because first they have to just identify the words that they don't understand. So basically, to be able to understand the story, they have to understand all the words, and by identifying difficult words, that will be the easiest part for them to do.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I think it's more like the calling words and just finding it without any higher order of thinking.
Yeah, just finding it.
Yeah.
So it's still between struggling and?
Struggling and maybe on level.
On level.
Is it possible?
It is possible, but it depends later because you are going to have the swap, yeah? Important to the plot. If you just find the words, that is easier. But if you ask them to find the words that are important to the story plot, sometimes it's higher a little bit. Okay. So it depends what activity. A while ago, you are.
We have a list of difficult words and important words.
Yeah,
so.
Maybe, but it's still on level. Yeah. Okay, thank you very much. Did you get something out of that? And then try to, any volunteers who wants to, we have one group more. Later, I will give chances. We have still another sharing for other. So, anybody? Any volunteers? Ah, your group? So, these other groups, we'll ask later. We have another activity. Okay. Because if we try to share now, at least what I'm aiming at, you get the whole point.
Good morning, everybody.
Morning.
My name is Astri, Yas, Sally, and Ibu Karnelis. We would like to share what we have already discussed. So we are going to start from the artful artist because we think that it is the easiest. The level is if it is easy, then easy for A, so the new students. So yeah, that's it. For the first, we are going to ask the students to draw. So they interpret the story by drawing. For example, like this. The expected drawing.
Oh.
There's the airplane. That represents the airplane and the airport. And then family, the writer, mother, father, and the sister. And I haven't got a chance to draw a teddy bear.
Yeah.
Something like that.
We'll draw that.
So they understand the story first by drawing the picture. That's it. And then after that, we continue with the second part.
All right. For the second part, we are coming to the, what is it, on level. So it would be the word wizard. Now, when I was doing this, I remember my students. the new students in Bukit Tinggi, or let's say in daerah, they didn't study. They don't study English in in SD 1, level 1, level 2, and 3. Sometimes even until 6, they don't study. So they come to Lia really, what is it, real beginners. Now, because of that, I have more words than our friends from the first group.
You have more words.
Okay. So here I have written down crowded, decided, walk away, look around, waiting area, scared, signal, gate, pick up. That's for the what is it? The difficult words. And for the important words to story plot, I have written down, what is it, planned a trip before crowded, and then go to the shop until it can be written, but I just make it long. And then look around. In look around, I write it in, I divide it into three. Look around ticket counter, and look around telephones, waiting area. And then after that, finally. So I just want the students to understand later what happened finally. So they will understand and they will remember the father calls the members of the family.
Okay.
And then sitting out and sleeping, corner, pretty beer, didn't walk, and then finally they go to the gate. Maybe this is too many. So
yeah, because you are a teacher. Yeah, but that is
at least I pretend to be my students who don't know much about the vocabularies.
Yeah,
and then
okay.
I think Ibu Astrid ever been there and really found difficulties, you know. The teachers are, I think what is better tell the situation.
That's a very good strategy then, yeah?
Okay. So
but, yeah, okay. Go on.
You will go on. But.
No. I mean, you have actually made it into a very, what is it? How do you call that? Very comprehensive then for the students to be able to really get the gist or the story out of the words. Yeah.
Yes.
The key words. So
yeah.
Training them actually to get the gist,
yes.
The key words first, and then so the key words is actually the key to get the gist of the story.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Thank you. All right, I think that's all from me.
Yeah, great. Yeah, okay. So what is the next?
The next is the discussion directories for on levels. I think for the levels it can be for higher EC students or for EP. Is it for until so the discussion structure here. I arranged the activity. I put them in a situation where they already arrived. After they read the text, and then I asked the students to imagine that they already arrived at the grandma's house. Yeah, and then there the grandma asks about the trip. And then I provide sets of cards with jumbled dialogues. So first I ask the students to work in groups or pairs, and then they have to arrange the jumbled dialogues into good dialogues. For example, like this, the first, how was your trip? And it's the grandma's word, the grandma's lines, yeah.
You create the question, the dialogue.
Yeah, I create, and then into sets of cards, so I share to them, and then they have to arrange into good orders. Okay, how was your trip? The grandma said that, and then it was great, but there was a little incident, and then the grandma will ask, what happened? So one of us got lost, and then continue until the next, until it gets all the stories. Yes, I think that's it.
Oh, yeah, it's very rich then. So what do you think about that? The students, where does it belong now?
On levels?
Like that, yeah?
I think that belongs to the post. Post reading. It belongs to the post reading already. But if anyway, the students, when we talk about the activity, usually it can be done by what level? The own level, the struggling, or the highly able?
I worked on the capable connector, so I provide some activities. One of them are teacher asks students to write down the story if they have ever experienced being lost somewhere, or teacher asks students to think if they have a family member or friend who got lost before. But the first activity will be they're making mind map first of who, where, how, when, why. After that, it's sort of like a brainstorming. After that, they make their own story. And then, or the student asks to discuss within a group of what to do when your family member got lost, or what to do when they self got lost, and they are going to present it. Or the student, teacher asks students to discuss within a group what things to do to avoid having a family member who got lost in a trip, and they are going to present it. But on the easy level, maybe I thought of something like, if you were the sister and you got lost, where would you go? If they come up with something like, I go to the security man, so I only ask them to draw the security man. Or maybe they would go, I'll go sleeping on the airport bench. Okay, then draw the airport bench. I guess that would be all.
So brilliant, yeah? That's why. Okay.
Actually, the idea of hours can be put in one teaching. One teaching. Started with a plan. This is to introduce the topic, and then after that continue with the vocabulary, to provide them with the vocabulary, and then we go to the reading itself. After reading, after some reading activities, then it will come to arranging the dialogues to gear them to what is it, more understanding of what it is, and then to help them prepare before they talk about their own experience.
So let's go to our question. You can go back to your seats. This is great. You're experimenting, sure, so you're able to get here. The purpose actually is giving this one with your kind of learners. They are, you are able to cater to